waiting on the screen of the serial. And I'm on my way, I'm on my way, and I'm heading home.
Sister in love. Although we're not sisters by blood, we considered ourselves sisters by heart. I first met my sister in love when my parents and I took a trip to Chicago to meet my brother's new girlfriend. As we entered their apartment, I remember seeing this beautiful young lady with long, wavy hair, happy eyes, and an inviting smile sitting on the couch, and wondering to myself, how did my brother get so lucky? Stephanie and I hit it off immediately. She had such a warm, engaging smile, and I knew at that moment that I would be lucky, too, if she chose to marry my brother. I recall the letter my brother sent me about the girl he was in love with, and he wrote, "Right now I'm in love with a girl named Stephanie. She's young but wise, very loving, lovely and very lovely, loving. I'm thinking seriously about making a commitment to her. She is strong-headed and believes in commitment." It didn't take long before they were married, and I found myself traveling this time to San Francisco to meet his firstborn, or her firstborn, Jeremiah. I vividly recall that little tiny baby and the look of wonderment on Stephanie's eyes. She said to me, "Isn't he beautiful? He's the most perfect thing." A few years later, Stephanie and family came to visit me in Los Angeles, this time with not only Jeremiah, but the new baby girl, Shauna. I remember the first thing Stephanie saying to me, "Oh, isn't she beautiful? She's the most perfect." After their visit, I drove them to the train station. I was carrying Jeremiah as we walked toward the train board. Steph was holding Shauna, and they boarded the train and proceeded to wave goodbye to me. When Stephanie realized that I still had Jeremiah in my arms, and we were waving goodbye to them, I'll never forget Stephanie calling out in panic, "My baby, give me my baby." She was so enamored with her new daughter that she completely forgot this was Jeremiah. I want to add in like an amendment of Jeremiah's The next baby, Christian, was born. Stephanie asked me and the Lord to be godparents at his baptism. The christening took place at St. John's Cathedral in Detroit, Michigan. The same church my parents were married in. Chris was dressed in a white satanic suit. Probably still satanic suit. Satin suit. Thanks for being married to Sean. White satin suit, and as the priest baptized him with the holy water, he smiled the biggest smile, and Stephanie whispered in my ear, "Oh, isn't he beautiful? He's just perfect." The fourth born baby came. The fourth baby named Corey, in parentheses, she wrote, "the best one." Arrived, and he was cute as a button. He was a little bundle of energy, and we liked to call him Corky. This name, my parents and I, Jesus Christ. Sorry. This time, my parents and I went to visit Stephanie and family in Windy Rock, Arizona. We all went to the Navajo Indian Reservation and toured the museum and library. After our visit, on the way back to the car, Corey ran ahead of us and climbed up on the trunk of Grandpa's car. Rays of sunshine were shining down on Corey's beautiful curly blonde hair. He looked like an angel. As Stephanie and I got closer to the car, she said to me, "Isn't he beautiful? He looks like an angel. Aw, just perfect. The most perfect one." I couldn't agree more, and I have the photo to prove. These are just some of the fond memories that I will always look back on and cherish. Of all of Stephanie's beautiful children that I have not had the opportunity to get to know, Brianna, Nika, Tyler, Jackson, and Chloe. Please know that my door will always be open to all of you, whatever the reason. I know that Stephanie loved each and every one of you with all of her heart. Although my heart is aching as I write this, realizing I will never have the opportunity to pick up a phone call or text her, I'll not say goodbye. Just bye for now and see you in heaven. I'll end with what she said in her last text to me. Love you. Stay cool, sister. Rest in peace, though, brother and friends.
guys, thanks for coming. I know my mom would have really appreciated it and see all of us get together and joke around. That was one thing. I wrote this morning for my mom. Dear Mom, how do I say goodbye to someone who wasn't ready to go? That's what makes this so much more painful. Some of my happiest memories were made with you. From the earliest, I remember eating chips and salsa, watching as the world turns, the up and down, round and rounds used to give me so I could fall asleep, and the great adventures of Mimi and Moo. I remember our long phone calls when I was off to some distant land where we talked about how we would go on an adventure together one day. Most of all, remember your sense of humor. Even if the conversation was sad or serious, we'd end up laughing at the end of our calls. Since I'm your son, I thought I would be the one making jokes that would make you feel uncomfortable, but somehow you always made me feel uncomfortable. How do I say goodbye? I'm not. I won't say goodbye, as I'm confident that if you decide not to return in my lifetime, that I'll see you in the next. I believe that our souls are interconnected for eternity, and time is only relative. It'll be a blink of an eye before we meet again. Hi. So I know in this lifetime, right to the end of it, fought like no one I've ever known, harder to hang on just for one moment more so we can be together a bit longer. I'll miss you every day when I crack a joke, or I eat chips and salsa, or watch as the world turns, or when I travel to another distant land. I told you I would stay here with you, and I did. I stayed, Mom. I love you, and I'll see you again. Love, Chris.
But I don't even know what to say, but I know she had the biggest heart and always accepted everybody for who they were. Didn't try to force anybody to be something they weren't. And she supported and loved us through everything. And if you ever needed encouragement, it didn't matter what time or when, it could have been 2 a.m, and she would always answer. Her phone was always connected to her, just so, because she had people everywhere, and she always wanted to be there for each of us. Somehow she managed to talk to us every day. She was on the phone with Brianna, or I had the pleasure. I'm so glad I did that. She lived with us for the last 2 months, and I was with her every second. And I was, you know, we would. Oh, you want to say something? Okay. Let's see. Love you, Grandma.
Grandma.
And she was her best friend for the last few months. She hid under Grandma's blankets every night at bedtime. And I'm like, where could she be? And she would be giggling, and Mom would be giggling. I don't know where she could be, Shauna. And she's like, shh, I'm keeping your secret. Even though I could hear her giggling on the blankets.
Okay.
Mom loved her enthusiastic self.
Okay.
She's going to be a superstar one day.
Yes.
Hello?
Hello? Okay, I love you, Grandma.
Hello.
She would... Okay. One more time.
Hello.
I love you, Grandma.
I love you.
Everybody's adventures and horse riding, watching the girls horse riding and taking Chloe to shows, and she loved her car. She drove and drove. If she couldn't drive, it drove her crazy at the end there that she couldn't go drive her car to wherever she wanted. She ain't not a homebody. She didn't matter where she went or what reason. She just wanted to drive, so, or ride her horse. So I hope she's has her car and her horse trailer, and they're driving to some amazing place, even though she can fly now because, you know, she's an angel. But just because she loved to drive. But I think it's whatever you want, it's whatever she wanted, what her best place was. So she will always forever be my best friend. And I'm so lucky that I had her for 3 minutes. It wasn't enough time, but I love her so much. Cora can. Want to talk some more? She's always running away. What can I say that hasn't already been said about my mom? She was the most incredible person. All the time she spent on us, and she would give every second. She was such a giver, and just trying to give us more time. I know she was. She was hanging out for us, and all the time she spent on us when we would be riding horses, and it'd be hours and hours and hours. She would just hang out in the car while we just putzed around. She was more than happy to do it. She loved us all with such a fierce love, and all her grandbabies. And I remember every day she'd ask for a new picture of Isla. If I didn't send it, she'd text me, "Where's my picture of Isla?" Well, the fierce love she showed all of us, I know that she taught us all to be wonderful parents. And we'll be able to show our babies that same love. I remember when I told her, I was like, "Oh my God, Mom, I don't know how you did it. 9 kids, you're a lunatic." The fact that you had an ounce of sanity after raising any of us. Yeah. She always hid in the car and called, "Mom, what are you doing? Hiding in the car." Why are you hiding? Oh, it's insane. But
why?
The love she's shown us, I know that I will know the same love, because how can you love anything? How can you love your children any other way when you're shown such an incredible, incredible strength? I love you so much, Mom. Just know that we all carry the same strength that you have. And we'll show our babies the same. I love you so much.
Starts. This has been quite a roller coaster. well. Going to college, being a young man, want to find your own way. I know that mom was there for every step. I remember the first time she took me up to college. Chris was there. We were pulling through, and the lady asked me if I could pull my mirror, and I pulled it, and it snapped. I go, I guess I was supposed to, but it's in now. And we spent half an hour getting it back up. Mom was there, you know, tears are coming down her face. She wasn't ready to let go of her baby boy. And I did it to find my own way. And every step that I took, if I ever needed someone to fall back on, she was there. So I'm incredibly grateful for the woman that she was and the love that she showed all of us. And I know that us as people, we carry that with us. So mom will always be with all of us. If you didn't have a mom, she's there for you as well. I love you, mom. See you in the next one.
So, if you don't know me, I am Greg's daughter, so Steph is my stepmom, and since I was like a year, I don't remember because she's been in my life that long, she was always my mom. I didn't live with them, obviously, but she would drive an hour and a half, sometimes a little bit longer, to pick me up from my guardian's house. And sometimes she'd be an hour and a half late. Sometimes she'd be on time. She was always late. But I could not say thank you to her enough there at the end for, you know, being a mom to me. It was really, really meant a lot. And my love of horses, she gave me that, and that was awesome. And so, you know, even as everybody knows, if she wasn't your mom, she was still your mom. She'll always be my mom. She loves all her kids. And I just really can't thank her. Sorry. A mother should show some of their children.
All right. So, I don't have anything prepared like Chris's amazing speech. It's like impossible to beat. And that, I've never been like a really good writer. But, you know, Mom's like always been there. Like whenever I'd call, she'd always be happy to hear from me. And she's always really fiercely protective over her kids. I'll put it like one of the best senses of humor. I know. If mom was up there last night, she would have had a blast. Because all of us were together. And I don't think anybody even cried last night.
To raising us all to adulthood. And I promise promise you, Mom, I will work so very hard and raise him. Give him all the love I possibly can the way you would.
So I'm one of Steph's stepkids, and I didn't meet her till I was 18, and even in the last 12 years, she's shown me more love than my real mother's ever shown me, and I don't even know how to explain it. I had a kid. I had no way to go get her. My mom told me I wasn't going to go get him. Steph said, get here now. We're taking you down there. I had to go 8 hours. And she dropped everything she had to go take me to meet my kid. Like, I don't even know how to describe it. Like, she means more to me than messed up to say, but my real mom, because she was there for the hard things. You could call her no matter what, and I'm sorry I can't look at everyone. It's hard enough holding it back, but looking at all of you makes it harder. We lost probably the best person I had ever been lucky enough to meet, and I wanted to share a little something, because I believe a little different than everyone else. In my belief, you die twice. You die when your physical body dies, and then you die again when you are removed, when nobody speaks of you or remembers you anymore. With how big her heart is and all the life she impacted, Ma, Steph will never experience that second death, and I personally can promise I will teach all of my kids the wonders and joys that she imparted in me in these 12 years that I've known her. She made an astronomical impact, and I guess bye for now. I'll see you after a while.
Oh wow, I didn't think I'd get this far. I didn't really have anything prepared either, but she taught me to be strong, lose gracefully.
Last 2 months, I tried to save her with my kids. I was there in the hospital when she died. But it wasn't the same way I tried to save our marriage together. This wasn't meant to be. So I tried my best then, I tried my best now. But, you know, I listen to how she's impacted you, and I see 5 more kids that I made since, and she made a bunch herself. We probably would have stayed together, we'd probably have 20 kids together. But she was like my muse, and I hope I was hers as well. I met her in Chicago, went to play music at a grand rond. My life with her has always been about music. And even a month ago, in the middle of trying to save her life, she inspired another song, which I won't do. It's entitled Chance to Begin Again. But I could probably never make it through this song. It's a great song. So she's always we kind of had our own lives, but we were always still very connected. And like I said, a month ago she inspired another song. So I hear how she's inspired many lives since. And so what is meant to be is meant to be. And I went ahead and fired 5 kids. She had another bunch for...
But then more heart.
Yeah, and then many kids that she took in, so. When I met her, I thought she was 27, I was 29. And one night, when I asked her to peel a potato, and she took the potato, and was taking the knife going like this, I was thinking to myself, she didn't never cook before. So then I sat down, I said, so how old are you anyway? She said, what does that matter? Well, it turns out that this woman I thought was 27 was actually 17. So, and onward and upward we went. And I said, didn't let age stop us. And very sad, she's gone. People of Ecuador love this song. Everybody loves this song. It's written by an amazing songwriter. It has a lot of meanings, like my son said. It can mean whatever you want. And so feel free to sing. Keep your mask on, if you can, of course. And we'll hear you.
Thank you. Everybody for who came, and of course those who couldn't come and send us all their love.
Our Grandpa and Vicky.
Grandpa and Vicky. Lots of laughs, lots of smiles. We're sitting there waiting for this book, because of course we couldn't be on time. That's just the way we are. And you know, Mom is one of those people that was always late, always supper time. While we're waiting, I was just looking around at all of you, and I don't see any tears. I don't see anybody crying. I see people laughing and telling jokes, and you know, that was Ma. We always found something funny in something. So, you know, wherever the universe may take you from this point, I know it's going to be good places because you got Ma with you. And I'll take her on my adventures with me everywhere I go. And, she's in all of you, so we will continue to live, and she'll live with us. And then when you have your kids, everybody that has their kids, you can steal those same things in there, and thus we're immortal. So keep that in mind. We're always immortal as long as we keep those feelings going. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Little bird fly away. I'll see you back someday. And on my way, on my way. Come in. Thank you.
Nice hat. Bonjour, Eiffel Tower, huh? Oui, oui, baguette. Buongiorno. It's me, Eiffel Tower baguette.
My chicken girl doesn't like to be on video. That's okay, you're still in the frame.
That's what you get. We have one behind. It's an ultimate tribute to mom, right?
Yeah, of course.
Hold down further.
Better be late and get to get there.
I'm gonna make a joke, but last time we were in the club,
did anybody come on yet?
Yeah.
Did anybody come on?
And the rest of you folks, I'm just going to have you step this way for just a minute so we can bring the hearse, the casket over, and then eventually we'll bring you back over here.
He's got it. Is there a backup? I know.
Square up to the grave side here and do watch your step here. You gotta step up a little bit on the planking. And then also it's gonna feel like the cast is getting away from you a little bit, but just readjust your grip and step that a little bit. Keep coming. Extend your arms here a little bit. Okay. Good job. Alright, folks, we're gonna kind of gather right over this area, like a little horseshoe, and you can go ahead and gather together with one another and keep each other warm. basic, typical prayers that we'd offer for anyone. And then we'll let you have some time here if anyone does want to take a moment at the casket. And then we are going to
put the
load of the casket shortly after we're done with the prayers. Okay? Our sister has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister, and together may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. Come you who are blessed by my Father, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. And Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the light. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Because God has chosen to call our sister from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he has risen the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace, and raise up her body on the last day. And with the longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace, and may her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Okay. Thank you.
Is there someone that you want to say a few words?
Chris. Yeah.
Well, I guess I'm going to say a few words. Thanks everybody for who came, and of course those who couldn't come and send us all their love.
Our Grandpa and Vicky.
Grandpa and Vicky. Lots of laughs, lots of smiles. We're sitting there waiting for this book, because of course we couldn't be on time. So that's just the way we are. Mom is one of those people that was always late, always supper time. But while we were waiting, I was just looking around at all of you. And I don't see any tears. I don't see anybody crying. I see people laughing and telling jokes. And, you know, that was Ma. We always found something funny in something. So, you know, wherever the universe may take you from this point, I know it's going to be good places because you got Ma with you. And I'll take her on my adventures with me everywhere I go. She's in all of you. So we will continue to live, and she'll live with us. And then when you have your kids, everybody that has their kids, you can seal those same things in there, and thus we're immortal. So keep that in mind. We're always immortal as long as we keep those feelings going. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Can you say bye, Grandma? Say bye, Grandma.
Oh, the baby.
Well, we'll let you guys finish up here.
This flooring, those curtains, bitch, listen, it's out, I'm gonna call my guys in, guys,
I got a
boys, let's get it done here, yeah, it's all you're good.
Thank you.
Cora.
Cora.
You dance? Dance for me?
Smile.
I'm gonna smile.
Comes up with a smile.